Yeah, Chris.
How you doing today?
Doing good.
I just want to make two quick points. The Democratic Party is going to lose the black vote. I'm be very clear. Simply because.
And what's your definition of lose the black vote? You mean Republicans will get a majority of black voters, or Democrats won't get as many black voters as they got in the last couple elections?
Most likely, it's going to be a repeat of 2016.
A repeat of 2016.
Some,
okay.
Yeah, some will sit out, and some will go to. Well, mostly black men will go to Trump.
Okay.
Simply because this force of this all blackness of Kamala and how y'all trying to force her into our community, and the black community continues to say that she is not black, in the fact of the context of American history, she is not black. Mm-hmm. I can trace my family to the American Revolution, the Civil War, and every war in America. Mm-hmm. Her family didn't come here until after the Civil Rights era. So
you're saying she doesn't black count?
Yeah. That's how we look at it.
That's how you look at it. You don't think Kamala Harris counts?
No. If God only challenged Jewish people and who they can pick and choose who is Jewish, then we feel like we can do the same thing. We can pick and choose who is black and part of our community.
And you can choose. People. You can choose to define. You can choose to define people however you want to define people. I am going to try to give people the benefit of the doubt of how they define themselves, and I'm going to try to not categorize people too narrowly because I'm not sure what I gain out of that. I'm not sure what I've learned out of that. Do I think that ultimately Kamala Harris is somebody who had an honest to goodness working class, middle class background, as very distinct from a lot of people who rise to power? Her life story resembles a lot more an average American than the person she's running against. Matches a lot more closely to people who have had to struggle in their lives than the person she's running against. So I am not. Go ahead.
It doesn't, like, she can't compare it to a person in the majority in the black community from the...
I'm comparing it to Donald Trump, man, because I'm not voting for her against anybody else other than Donald Trump. Who has had to face privilege versus who has had to face struggle? Kamala Harris has had to face struggle. Do you disagree?
No, she hasn't. Really, she was raised in California. And
stay on the phone. Who do you think faced more struggle, Trump or Kamala Harris?
Need one of them, personally.
You're listening to Tom Hartman.
But I will say that anybody who thinks that Kamala Harris had as easy as a life as Donald Trump is not paying attention to the same stuff I am. So, Chris, stick with us for a moment. What do you want Kamala Harris to do about it?
Well, I support Trump because I want to end immigration.
Got it. So now I understand. So you're a Trump supporter, and when you say your prediction is that Kamala is going to lose black voters, it's because you want Kamala to lose black voters because you don't want more immigrants coming to this country. You want to close down the border.
Not only that, just how the bourgeoisie of the black community, or the facial black community, which are mostly black immigrants who come over here and misrepresent us. Like, if you look at every politician that is in the office, they are first or second generation black immigrants.
I'm having a hard time hearing you.
If you look at the politicians who are in the Senate or just in public office, majority of them are first and second black immigrants.
Let me ask. Do you characterize yourself as someone in the middle class, someone in the upper class, or something lower than that? Are you rich, middle class, less, class. More?
Between middle class and low.
I missed the answer. I'm sorry. You can consider yourself rich, upper class, middle class, working class, or something else?
Working.
Sorry about that. We're having a little clipping on the phone. We'll need to get to the bottom of that. So if we're thinking about supporter, give me my chance. I don't know you're a Trump supporter, but I still think
I've been a lifelong Democrat.
I still think you ought to, give me a chance. I still think you ought to give Kamala Harris a chance, because if you're a working class voter, the tax policies are going to be passed. The jobs policy are going to be passed by Project 2025, by the right wing, by the Republican Party, that they have done throughout my lifetime and yours, that will get more and worse under Trump, is going to matter a lot more than a border deal that would have happened. Like, we'd have different border policy right now if Trump hadn't killed that. We'd have a bit different border policy right now. So if you say, I pick immigration over everything else, I think for your best interest, setting aside race, for your best interest, you should at least consider Kamala Harris with a little greater consideration.
No. She's
Let me ask a couple questions.
Like
Do you think
the black community, she's another Obama.
I don't think you can speak as a black. You can speak as a black man, and I can't. Neither of us can speak for an entire community. But I would say this. I would ask this. Do you think climate change is real?
No.
Okay. Do you think that a woman should have a right to an abortion?
It depends on the situation.
Do you think that she should get to decide that situation, or do you think the government should get to decide that situation? Should she have a right to choose?
I feel like it's supposed to be medical only, or in the life of the mother or race.
God, okay, so you're the Republican. You're a right-wing guy. Okay, I mean, that's up to you. That's up to you. But I don't think we should go there and convince, therefore, Democrats or black Democrats to think that somehow Kamala Harris doesn't count because she has one parent who's from South Asia. I don't think that's cool, man. I'm going to try to get like seven people in like 4 minutes. We're going to do our best. Joe from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, you're on the air.
I'm going to try and do this. I had something else worked out, but I did want to address Chris just for a minute. Yeah. And I want to tell him he's being mentally poisoned by the social media people that I refer to as paid liars. They know better, but they're getting paid to provide disinformation. But what he really doesn't know is the real history. It's the laws that govern the border. What Trump did was proclamations. What Biden has just done recently is a proclamation. They're all being challenged in court. We need new laws. Who blocked the law in 2015? Something Chris doesn't know. John Boehner, Republican. Who killed the border bill that just came up recently? The Republicans, Donald Trump. Who deported the most illegals of any president? Obama. Bush let the most stay in. So he's just got his problem is he's got the wrong target. The target is corporate America.
Yeah, no, I hear you, Joe. And the other thing that we learned is, I mean, I enjoyed talking to that guy, but, you know, that guy doesn't think women should have a right to choose, and that guy doesn't think climate change is real. So,
exactly.
Right wings of all stripes. It's got